Aquariuses, what is going on with you this week? Okay. So a couple different things. We have on Monday the 4th, you in love. And that can mean a new love, literally. It can mean a love partner that you've had and you're accustomed to, but the relationship itself seeming fresh and new in some capacity. I think that this could be anyone who makes you feel more love in your heart. So I saw you talking and I saw you being very joyful and having more fun, being pretty animated. And it was sort of like the life of, the conversation, sort of the life of the party, even though there weren't a ton of other people there. It was just this feeling of high vibrational energy. And it was very healing in its own way. I felt, though, for many of you, this is quite literally a new love partner or an old love partner returned or something like this. And it trickled over into Tuesday the 5th. And I heard keep it light. So I think that it's great when we get, involved with someone and we're feeling like really rejuvenated or on fire or passionate about the relationship. But if you know it's kind of not going to be there forever, it's not your end all be all, it's not a long-term relationship. I think that as long as you're both really honest about that and you both just decided to come to the table and be like, let's enjoy it for what it is, that's great. And I would keep it right about there. Okay. Now, on Thursday the 7th, there's talk of your inner child receiving some insight and being renewed. So there could be parts of your personality that have been hidden away for a really long time, playful, imaginative, maybe a little less guarded, more loving and forgiving, okay? Things like this, definitely creative. And I see it coming out more. And I think that you really need to celebrate that and give it the time. So I don't care if it's something like in the middle of a conversation, you want to make a silly joke, I feel like then take the time to make it. Stop poo-pooing everything. That is also important, okay, to tap into that inner child. It's part of your spiritual growth and development right now. On Friday the 8th, there is talk of bad habits that might be trickling over into Saturday the 9th. So if you're drinking, if you're using, if you're, just popping a few more pills, even prescription, than you normally do, if you're overeating, self-indulgence, escapist tendencies, whatever it is, okay, avoidance, we want to really nip that in the bud right there. Friday the 8th, Saturday the 9th, or there will be some consequences to that later on in the week, okay? So find another way to process. How do you process? How do you process if you're used to being numbed out? Well, you're going to have to get comfortable being uncomfortable. It takes practice. Allow. Just allow. It's okay to feel things and try to be more of an observer and not so much of an absorber. Okay, I pretend sometimes that I'm an eagle flying up above a storm instead of being like all the other birds that are looking for shelter in the trees. Kind of if you could just sort of watch the situation and not consider yourself as being the situation, it can help a lot with staying still and not numbing out. Okay, there was talk here of someone coming to you on Saturday the 9th, and I'm not positive that it won't be more like Sunday or around that time, being very frank about their understanding that they maybe no longer fit in your life, or they're leaving, or they've made a choice with their life to go off and do something new. So whether someone's getting married, or they quit their job, or they're relocating, or it could be anyone from your boss to a family member to a child. I just think that somebody's coming to you and they're sort of dropping this bomb, and it's like, what? Wow, okay. Now it's not happening to you, but obviously you're in a relationship with them. And so I think that it's important for you to also be frank about it. You know, if you feel that you need to say, wow, I really would have liked to have known about that. You know, this is, I'm a little startled, whatever it is, but they seem to be a little cold and a little short and abrupt. And I think that, hey, it is what it is. That's their energy and that's their journey. I do feel on Sunday the 10th that you may have more of an opportunity to talk it out. And so if this is something more of a situation in your own life that is abruptly ending, or you're getting a final answer, a closing of a chapter on that thing, I think it would be good for you to talk it out if you understand it more that way. But it's sort of like if through the process of speaking, you come in touch with where your feelings are with it and what your level of peace is also in going forward. Okay, so that could help you a lot. Okay, Aquariuses, have a great week.